for Christmas, Abby?
I really hope I get a monkey.
I'm really hoping that I will get a hedgehog. What do you want, Lydia?
Well, I definitely want some cats because they're really fuzzy and just fun to play with.
I'm hoping I'll get a hamster, too.
Yeah, I also want a hamster, maybe even a guinea pig. But most of all, I probably would want a hedgehog.
You deserve more.
My mom needs to get me some necklaces.
Yes.
Don't you guys just love Christmas? All the fun and the holiday cheer.
My mom has to get me necklaces and bracelets and earrings and rings and all the animals that I want.
Remember, you deserve it.
I just need some fuzzy things to keep me warm at Christmas because it's so cold and everything's so boring.
I have to get earrings. I have to get a doll because I love dolls. And I have to have a hedgehog.
I need, like, she better get me little critters.
If I don't get some cats and dogs and fuzzy animals and fuzzy coats and fuzzy things, then I'm going to be freezing and I'll die of a frostbite or something. There's probably plenty of other things you could get from being so cold. I need all these things. I have to have them. And if I don't get them, I don't know what I'm going to do.
Why do we even get presents at Christmas time?
I don't know.
Yeah. Faith, look.
Oh, children, what foolish, silly little female Baptistlings art thou? Why do we get presents? Because we have parents who love us and care for us and cherish us, and so they spoil us rotten, and this is why you all get presents. I know these things, for I am the ghost of Christmas presents. That's presents, P-R-E-S-E-N-T-S, by the way, not presents. It's spelled with different letters, you understand. Makes different noises when you say them, has different definitions. Some children don't understand that it doesn't matter whatever present it is you have to have. In my former life, growing up in Springfield, Missouri, I wanted a Kodak camera. And I got it. And it broke within 6 weeks. And it was never replaced. And I came across it in an old box of old toys, each promising to bring me happiness and joy, like a hedgehog or a fuzzy thing or a monkey. All of these animals will just poop and die. They will not bring lasting happiness, for presents are not the true meaning of Christmas. Oh! Little children, heed my warning. I speak from all of the broken promises and dreams of the Christmas presents of the past that you might have in your future. I am warning thou. Hedgehogs are stupid presents. Monkeys are the scourge of India. Trust me, I've been there in my former life. I have boxes of shoes and Xbox games. I have tons of Star Wars figurines and Legos, and they didn't bring lasting happiness. All of their dreams died, and they represent the sadness and the loss of misplaced Christmas hopes. My sweet, dear Baptist children, hear my warning. Physical presents cannot make you happy, They are not the true meaning of Christmas. You must find the true meaning of Christmas so you don't end up like me.
Oh. It definitely is better to give than to receive. The whole reason we celebrate and give gifts at Christmas is to remember that about 2,000 years ago, God gave us the best gift we could ever receive. Something that we couldn't buy or earn, and something that we desperately needed, but that no one else could give to us. The Bible talks about this gift in several different passages. Romans 6:23 tells us, "For the wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord." In Ephesians 2:8, "For by grace are ye saved through faith, and that not of yourselves, it is the gift of God." 2 Corinthians 9:15 says, "Thanks be to God for his unspeakable gift." And in Romans 5:18, "Therefore, as by the offense of one, judgment came upon all men unto condemnation. Even so, by the righteousness of one, the free gift came upon all men unto justification of life." A few years ago, I came across this drawing, and I think it's a pretty cool representation of the Christmas story and also of the verse that I just read. Here you see Eve, and she's looking pretty sad and sorrowful and ashamed because, as you know, she has fallen into temptation. It was her free will, her choice, and she and Adam have sinned. And as the verse says, because of that sin, that offense of one, judgment came upon all men unto condemnation. And then on the other side of the drawing, you see Mary. And she looks hopeful because she knows that God is using her to bring Jesus, to bring hope and salvation through the world. And at the bottom, you kind of see a little bit of the serpent, and he thinks that he's got victory on Eve with his tail wrapped around her legs and around her ankle. But in the end, we know that it is actually the baby that Mary's carrying, Jesus, that will ultimately have victory over him. God loved us. God loves us still. He wanted to have a relationship with us, to walk with us like he did with Adam and Eve in the garden. So with the ultimate expression of love, God sent us the greatest gift we will ever receive. He sent Jesus. Jesus, who was fully God, made himself small and vulnerable as a baby. This is the true meaning of Christmas. It isn't about the presents under the tree, or the decorations, or the songs we hear and sing. It's a day where we remember the incredible gift that God gave us in order to restore our relationship with him. And it truly is a gift. You don't have to do anything to receive this gift. In fact, you can't do anything to receive it. It's given to us freely by faith alone in the death, burial, and resurrection of Jesus, because yes, the gift of Christmas is inseparable from the resurrection we celebrate at Easter. And do you know what else? We get to be heralds sharing the good news of the true gift of Christmas. We can say to others, "Do you know where my hope comes from? There is a peace that passes understanding. Have you felt the love of God? Let me tell you about the joy of my salvation." This is the true gift and meaning of Christmas. God came to earth to make a way and even to die for us because he loves us. And as it says in John 15:13, "Greater love hath no man than this, that a man lay down his life for his friends." And from Luke 2:10-11, "And the angel said unto them, Fear not, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which shall be to all people. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, which is Christ the Lord. Merry Christmas, everyone.
Christmas cookies, sugar. I sure do like those Christmas cookies, babe. The ones that look like Santa Claus, Christmas trees and bells and stars. I sure do like those Christmas cookies, babe.
What does a gingerbread man put under his blankets? A cookie sheet.
Now Christmas cookies are a special treat. The more she bakes, the more I eat. And sometimes I can't get myself to stop. Sometimes she'll wait till I'm asleep, and she'll take the ones that I didn't eat and put those little sprinkly things on top. I sure do like those Christmas cookies, sugar. I sure do like those Christmas cookies, babe. The ones that look like Santa Claus.
Why did Rudolph get such bad grades in school? Because he went down in history.
Those trees and bells and stars. I sure do like those Christmas cookies, babe. Now those sprinkly things just make things worse, because it makes them taste better than they did at first. And they're absolutely impossible to resist. Some disappear to who knows where, but I make sure that I get my share, and those kids just stand there waiting for the ones I miss.
What does the grumpy sheep say? Bah, humbug.
I sure do like those Christmas cookies, sugar. Sure do like those Christmas cookies, babe. She gets mad if they're all gone before she gets the icing put on. Sure do like those Christmas cookies, babe. Now there's a benefit to all of this that you might have overlooked or missed. So now let me tell you the best part of it all. Every time she sticks another batch in the oven, there's 15 minutes for some kissing and a hugging. That's why I eat Christmas cookies all year long. Oh, take it away, boys.
What does one snowman say to the other snowman? You're cool.
I sure do like those Christmas cookies, sugar. I sure do like those Christmas cookies, babe.
How do reindeer know when it's Christmas? They check their calendar.
The ones that look like Santa Claus, Christmas trees and bells and stars. I sure do like those Christmas cookies, babe. I sure do like those Christmas cookies, babe. Yeah.
We wish you a Merry Christmas. We wish you a Merry Christmas. We wish you a Merry Christmas. And a Happy New Year!
We are going to read the legend of Saint Nicholas. I can't believe it's Christmas Eve. Nick followed his dad through the snow-dusted parking lot. Not my idea of fun, he muttered. Hey, You're the one who waited until the last minute to buy Christmas gifts for your little brothers, Dad reminded him. True, Nick admitted. Why was it so much easier to think about getting gifts than giving them? Have you ever wondered such a thing? It's a lot easier to make a wish list for yourself, isn't it? Nick spotted a skinny Santa ring a bell and collecting for the poor. Dad handed Nick a dollar for Santa's kettle. Nick thought about adding something from his own wallet, but he was hoping to have enough left to get himself a CD. A CD is a round disc that people like your parents used to play music on. It's like a DVD, but it doesn't play movies. Just
sounds boring.
Well, there used to be whole stores full of them. Once inside the crowded store, Nick smelled hot dogs and popcorn. Scratchy Christmas music blared overhead. He dodged a shopping cart. You get your gifts, and I'll see to this list your mother gave me, Dad called, disappearing into the sea of shoppers. Nick headed for the toy aisle, but a rack of CDs caught his eye. A few minutes later, he heard a deep voice saying his name. The voice belonged to a store Santa.
Santa used to go by the name Nick, or Saint Nicholas,
he heard the Santa say to a group of children in the elf room. Nick remembered waiting for his parents in that room when he was a little kid.
A long, long time ago, the store Santa continued, in a country far across the sea, a boy named Nicholas was born.
Nick leaned against the doorway and listened. Nicholas's parents were very rich. They traveled all over the world with their son. When Nicholas was 8, they visited beautiful gardens in the Far East. Nicholas noticed children begging for food. When Nicholas turned 10, his parents took him to the West. Nicholas couldn't sleep at night because he kept thinking about the longing eyes of the children in the streets, children who had certainly never owned a toy.
That sounds awful.
On his 12th birthday, Nicholas and his family journeyed to the north. Nicholas waved to the children playing in the snow. Why aren't they wearing coats and hats? He asked. His parents exchanged sad looks. They probably don't own coats and hats, Nicholas, his father said. A few years later, they visited the Holy Land, where baby Jesus had been born that first Christmas. In this holy place, God gave us the greatest gift ever given, Nicholas's father remarked. Imagine how much God loves us to give us his only son. Wise kings brought gifts for the Christ child to honor and celebrate this amazing gift, Nicholas's mother said, as the church bells rang out. Not long after they returned home, Nicholas's parents died. Nicholas felt lost and alone. He had plenty of money, but no idea what to do with his life. He looked to his friends for help. If I had that much money, said Joseph, I'd pay all of our bills because my father is out of work. I would buy my mother a warm coat, Thomas added. Phoebe gazed at the stars. My two sisters want to marry, but we don't have the money that's required from the bride's family. If I had the money, I would give it to my sisters for this dowry, she sighed. And if I had enough, I would do the same for myself. Nicholas knew that his friends would never get their wishes unless... What do you think he should do?
I think he should give them the money.
Yeah? That night, Nicholas talked things over with God. Father, could this be the work you have for me? As if in answer, the church bells rang. Nicholas remembered what his mother had said about the wise kings bringing gifts to baby Jesus. He thought of what his father said about Jesus being the greatest gift. What better time to give gifts than on Jesus' birthday? Nicholas could barely hold in his excitement. First, he tromped through falling snow to Joseph's house. He opened a window and tossed in enough gold coins to allow them to buy their own home. Next, he woke the town tailor and bought his finest coat. Nicholas ran all the way to Thomas's house and stuffed the coat through the open shutters. Nicholas's last stop was Phoebe's house. He tied coins into 3 bags for 3 dowries and searched for an open window. Nicholas was about to give up when he looked to heaven and prayed for God's guidance. That's when he thought of the chimney. On Christmas Day, Nicholas's friends came running to his house. "It's a miracle," Joseph exclaimed. "God must have heard my prayers." "We were given a gift as well," Thomas began. "My mother hasn't taken off her new coat since she found it this morning." Phoebe's eyes sparkled like sunlight on snow. "My sisters will marry next month." She smiled at Joseph. "Now I too can marry." We don't know who else to thank, so we thank God. Overcome with joy, Nicholas understood his mission in life. This is how he would celebrate Christmas from now on. Would you guys have been able to keep it a secret that you were the one that gave the gifts? I don't think I would either. That was pretty selfless of him, wasn't it? When the story ended, Nick shook himself. A part of him was back with Nicholas. He could imagine how good it must have felt to secretly give his friends what they had wanted most. Nick had almost forgotten why people gave presents at Christmas. He wanted to feel that same joy of giving. "Nick, time to go." Dad walked up, his arms full of shopping bags. "We can't go yet, Dad." What does he still need to do?
He still needs to buy gifts for his little brothers.
Yeah. Nick never imagined buying gifts could be so much fun. He found just the right toys for his brothers. Then he spent everything he had left on toys for the poor. "I wish I'd had enough to fill the whole collection box," he told Dad. Nick felt sure he'd never look at Christmas the same way. He wanted to remember the gifts of St. Nicholas, the gifts of the wise kings, and most of all, God's gift of baby Jesus. I hope you guys will go to bed tonight thinking about the legend of St. Nicholas and how good he felt to give gifts to his friends in need. Are you ready for bed?
Yeah.
All right. Let's go get tucked in for bed.
Ooh, silent night, holy night, all is calm, all is bright, round yon virgin mother and child.
Have everlasting life. it's Christmas, the time of the year for singing and toys and holiday cheer. Presents are something so small. What is the point of it all? It's Christmas, the very best day when you fill up with love and give it away. This year, you better believe it's better to give than receive. It's 2020 and we're blue. We've kept our distance, but I have so missed you. Tell me, family, do you recognize me? Well, been quite a year, it doesn't surprise me.
Merry Christmas.
When you see gifts, can you chill? You're acting like that green monster from Whoville. Maybe Christmas doesn't come from a store. Maybe Christmas perhaps means a little bit more. It's Christmas, the time of the year for singing and toys and holiday cheer. Presents are something so small. What is the point of it all? Crown in room, mom with tired eyes. You open your gifts and then you start to cry. My child, I thought you were someone who knew the best gift, salvation through Jesus. That's the Christmas message. Face of a child who didn't get what they want, the pouting in tears, then they remember the sadness.
Oh no, I didn't want them to find out the true meaning of Christmas. Now I'll never win.
In the spirit of Wild Arrows, we have decided that we were going to ad lib our goodbye for the Wild Arrows Christmas special. That means that we haven't planned anything because we're lazy. But it is nonetheless sincere that we love the kids of Wild Arrows and Wildwood Baptist Church because they have such awesome parents and they produce such awesome children.
Right.
Right?
Right.
The greatest kids in the world are Wildwood kids. And we love you very much, and we do hope that you can remember the true meaning of Christmas this year. Kim, what do you have to say?
Just, you said it all, but yes, we do love you guys. We love all the little kids that are around at church and just their smiles and their love for Jesus. And we're hoping you have a great Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year.
Now it's time to say goodbye to the kids of Wildwood. M-E-R-R-Y.
C-H-R-I-S-T-M-A-S.
Merry Christmas, kids. Merry Christmas.